Hoy terminamos el folleto. Nos ubicamos en esa página. Vamos a terminar de practicar los phrasal verbs. Para los que vamos ingresando, ubiquémonos en esa página, porfa. Vamos a ver unas dos páginas de gramática. Y de ahí vamos a terminar con unos ejercicios de conversación. 30 segundos y comenzamos. Nos vamos ubicando en esa página, porfa, donde dice underline the correct preposition to complete the phrasal verbs. Nos ubicamos, thank you, nos ubicamos, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay. Welcome to your class. Today we are going to complete the topic about phrasal verbs. This is a homework, so we are going to compare my answers to your answers. So I have the meaning of every single phrasal verb. For example, number one, lots of fruits and vegetables will help you get over your cold. Para cada phrasal verb que tengo acá, tengo el significado. Para que usted diga, teacher, ¿y por qué utilizaron esa palabra y no esta? Al finalizar, cuando completemos todas las respuestas, les voy a decir por qué fue que se eligieron esas respuestas para que usted diga, ah, ok, now I got it. Ok, letter B. Can you please, Ale Martínez, can you please turn on your audio? Solamente ayúdame, hija, a leer literal B. Thank you.
I never try out. Of unclothed before bullying stem. It takes so much time.
¿Qué phrasal verb voy a ocupar? Por ejemplo, el phrasal verb principal es try. Try. I never try. Sería I never try up, try off, or try on. Try up, okay. Another opinion. Try up, try off, or try on.
On.
Por ahí escuché un on. Another opinion.
Creo que try on, ajá.
Porque okay.
Dice que antes de comprarlo, ajá. Try
okay.
On.
Sí, let's try see. On. En the correct answer, uy, la primera no tenía respuesta. Ah, sí, ya la tenía, pero yo lo volví a cerrar. Yes, the correct answer is try on. I never try on clothes before buying them. It takes too much time. Recuerde que le voy a explicar por qué el de la respuesta. Can you please, Mari? Letter C, thank you.
My mom says I take into down after my grandmother because I talk too much.
So the correct one is take into, take down, or take after. Todos podemos opinar, okay?
I take after for me, Bea. I take after my grandmother. Uh-huh.
Okay, another opinion. Another opinion. Hey, tengo, ¿cuántos estudiantes tengo? Tengo casi 10 estudiantes. Opinions. Equivoquémonos, equivoquémonos. No se preocupe que yo tengo. Ok. Pero dice take down. Ajá. My mom says I take into, or I take down, or I take after my grandmother because I talk too much. 5, 4, 3, 2. Let's see. And the correct answer is take after. No se preocupe que yo tengo las respuestas de por qué hemos elegido esas palabras. Ahorita solamente quiero completar todo. Letter D, can you please, Carlita, I suggest
talking on taking down a sport to help him lose weight.
I suggest taking down a sport to help him lose weight.
Taking up.
Okay. Taking up. Okay, let's see the answer. Take down. I suggest taking down a sport to help him lose weight. Miren, los phrase adverbs son un poquito complicados. ¿Se acuerdan que yo les dije que era un poquito complicado? Porque muchas veces, así como se escribe, pero en este caso, por ejemplo, si yo pongo take es tomar y down es abajo. Tomar abajo, pero ya van a ver ustedes cuando es un phrase adverb cambia totalmente su significado. Kevin, can you please help me to read letter E?
Okay. Look up, look out, or look on. You're going to drop that if you're not careful.
So, the correct one. Look up, look out, or look on.
Up, look up.
Look up.
Okay. Let's see. Look out. Ya vamos a ver por qué. Look out. Traigo todos los significados, no se preocupe. Look out, you're going to draw that if you're not careful. Si no tienes cuidado. Letter F. Can you please, Neri?
Letter qué? F.
Letter F, yes.
He says he's going to give him up into shopping on the internet because he spent too much money.
So the correct answer is he said he's going to give in, give up, or give into. Give in, give up, or give into.
Give up.
Give.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Another opinion.
Give up.
Okay, let's see. Yes, give up into shopping on the internet because he spends too much money. Letter G, can you please, Vero, help me to read letter G? That job
is too good.
That job is too good to turn up, turn down, or turn off.
Turn down.
Okay, let's see. Turn down. Muy bien. Letter H. Naomi, can you please? Thank you, Naomi. Your microphone is off. You should. Letter H.
You should take your hat in over off in the cinema. People will get angry with you.
So the correct, permítame, solo le voy a mandar un mensaje a Rachel porque aquí estoy desde que iniciamos la clase. Yo creo que el internet de ella es el que no funciona. Okay. Yes, you should take your hat in, over, or off?
Off.
Okay, let's see. Nice. You should take your hat off in the cinema. People will get angry with you. Thank you. Okay, letter I. Can you please, Israel, can you please help me to read? She has
to look on or in or after her younger brother when her parents are out.
Excellent. The correct one. She has to look on, looking, or look after her younger brother. Let's see. After. Yes. After. Teacher, pero arriba también utilizamos after. Ya les voy a decir por qué lo utilizamos dos veces. And the last one, can you please... uy, ya todos participaron. Volunteer. ¿Quién me lee la última? Thank you.
I have lots of shopping and people were angry with me because I was holding on of the queue.
Excelente, muy bien, Vero. Solamente te equivocaste. La palabra UP no se lee up. Se lee con A. Up. Up. Okay. Excelente, Verito. I had a lot of shopping and people were angry with me because I was holding off, or holding up the queue.
Holding up.
Let's see. Holding up the queue. Hey, teacher, ¿y qué es esa última palabra? Queue.
Es fila.
Muchísimas gracias. Una fila, una línea. Cuando usted va a pagar al súper y dice, ay, mira qué larga está la fila, mira qué larga está la línea, dicen en otros países. Ok. Vamos con el primer phrasal verb. El primero que utilizamos fue, en este caso, get over. ¿Qué significa el phrasal verb get over? Superar. Superar. Por ejemplo, dice, lots of fruit and vegetables will help you to get over your cold. O sea, mucha fruta y muchos vegetales te ayudarán a superar tu resfriado. Get over. En el segundo utilizamos try on. El phrasal verb try on se utiliza para la ropa cuando decimos solo probala. O sea, probátela a ver si te queda la blusa, probate a ver si te queda el pantalón. So, just try on. Solo proba a ver si te queda. Entonces, I never try on clothes before buying them. Yo nunca me pruebo o me mido la ropa antes de comprarla. ¿Por qué? It takes too much time. Me toma demasiado tiempo. En la letra C ocupamos el phrasal verb take after. Que en este caso, take after es un phrasal verb que tiene two meanings. Meaning number one, cuidar de. Y meaning number two, parecerme a. Por ejemplo, my mom says, I take after my grandmother because I talk too much. Mi mamá dice que yo me parezco a mi abuela porque hablo mucho. Demasiado. Hablo mucho. Entonces, el phrasal verb take after significa cuidar de, o en este caso, como en esta oración, me parezco a. Literal de. I suggest taking, ocupamos take up. Ahí se me fue hasta down. I suggest taking up a sport to help him lose weight. En este caso, el phrasal verb take up significa ocupar tu tiempo en.
Pero él no había dicho take down.
No, les dije que se me había ido el down hasta allá. Rayita. Ajá. Se me había ido la rayita hasta allá. Pero es up. Up, take up. Ahora bien, en el caso de take up, significa ocupar tu tiempo en. Yo te sugiero, I suggest, que tomes tu tiempo en qué?
En ayudar, en
a sport.
Haciendo a deporte sport. Para bajar de peso.
Para que baje de peso. Take up. Yes, Neri.
Yo verifiqué take up y me apareció como comenzar.
En este caso, take up, según la información que yo tengo del libro, acuérdense que yo lo tengo cotejado con el libro de gramática. Ajá. Entonces, take up es ocupar tu tiempo en. Puede ser que pueda también tener ese significado. Pero aquí en el libro acotejado, sí, en este caso sería ocupar tu tiempo en un deporte.
Pero igual con la oración.
Sí, aplica. aplicaba. Sí aplica, sí. Pero yo lo estoy haciendo según la regla gramática del libro de Cambridge, que yo tengo acá. Aquí, en este caso, no se preocupen porque el libro que yo tengo, que yo ocupo con ustedes, es de Cambridge y tiene las respuestas también. Así que igual, en ese caso de taking down.
Okay.
¿Usted lo encontró, Neri, como taking down o take down?
Es taking up.
Taking up.
Y sí, para mí me pareció como comenzar y lo vi lógico con la oración.
Ok, siempre entonces sería take up.
Ajá.
Ok, thank siempre. You. Nice. Ok, muy bien. Letter E. El phrasal verb que utilizamos fue look out, que en este caso es tener cuidado. Look out, you're going to drop. Este drop es un verbo que significa botar o lanzar también. You're going to drop that if you're not careful. O sea, ten cuidado porque puedes tirar o lanzar eso si no tienes cuidado. Careful. En la letra F ocupamos give up, que es el phrasal verb, uno de los phrasal verb más comunes que hay, que significa rendirse. He said he's going to give up shopping on the internet because he spends too much money. Él dijo que va a renunciar de comprar en internet porque gasta demasiado dinero. Vamos con la letra G. El phrasal verb que utilizamos fue torn down. Tiene dos significados. Renunciar o dejar, que viene siendo lo mismo, abandonar. Torn down. That job is too good to turn down. Ese trabajo es demasiado bueno para dejarlo o para renunciar o para abandonarlo. Yo creo que aquí caben los tres significados. Turn down. Ese trabajo es demasiado bueno para renunciar. Bueno, yo ocuparía renunciar. H. You should, en este caso utilizamos take off, que significa quitarse. You should take your hat off. Yo te recomiendo que te quites tu sombrero en el cine. People will get angry with you. Porque las personas se pueden enojar contigo. En el siguiente utilizamos take after. Que ese yo creo que fue de los primeros phrasal verbs que ustedes se aprendieron. Que significa cuidar de. Tiene entonces parecerme a o cuidar de. She has to look after her younger brother when her parents are out. Ella tiene que cuidar de su hermano pequeño o su hermano menor o su hermano más joven cuando sus papás están fuera. Take after. Y el último phrasal verb que utilizamos fue holding up, que significa en este caso haciendo. I had lots of shopping and people were angry with me because I was holding up the queue. O sea, yo estaba haciendo una gran fila. Tenía muchos comprados, había comprado mucho y la persona estaba enojando conmigo porque se estaban atrasando porque ya yo estaba haciendo una gran fila de los comprados que yo había hecho. ¿Alguna duda, señores, o alguna consulta? Yes.
Sí, yo tengo, creo que en la literal, en el literal, ¿y cómo se dice? Y en inglés.
Ay, yes, she has.
Ay, como que sí, como que ha habido un error porque es look after y usted puso take after.
Take after, fue error mío de escritura nada más, pero es look after. Ajá. Tiene en este caso look after. Thank you, Neri.
Y el otro está en el age, que es, no sé si es habla sobre quitarse.
Quitarse, take off.
No sé si a la oración le faltó porque dice you should take your hat. Ahí lo único que sí es como que yo noto es que la palabra no va
unida. Está lejos, ajá.
Eso.
Podemos, podemos decir, de hecho creo que vimos en una clase que la palabra está, bueno, no fue una clase, en el libro, en el material que yo les he dado, hay dos ejemplos que dice take your shoes off y hay otro que dice take off your shoes. Nos daba la regla que podíamos ocupar en ese caso la palabra junta o la palabra separada. Sí. Entonces, aquí en este caso puedo decir take off your hat o take your hat
ajá,
off.
Sí, medio, ya vi un tutorial de eso, de los transitivos.
Ajá, excelente, muy bien, Neri, la felicito. Y fíjense que en el, ¿cómo se llama? En el material que yo les doy, salía el ejemplo, pero creo que era de los zapatos, si no me equivoco, pero decía take off your shoes y decía take your shoes.
Este es off. Un phrasal verb transitivo, entonces.
Un intransitive phrasal verb. Excelente, Neri, la felicito. Muy bien. Intransitive phrasal verb. ¿Por qué? Porque puede ser las palabras juntas o en este caso la palabra separada. Excelente. Nice. Another opinion. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ok. I have a question. I need, let's see. Kevin, activemos micrófono, okay. Porfa. ¿Cuál es tu opinión, hijo, acerca de los phrasal verbs?
¿En inglés o en español?
Whatever you want. If you want, you can say it in Spanish. If you want, you can say it in English.
There are so confused because if you don't know it, you think that any word has a literal meaning.
Yes. And according as I said at the beginning, some phrasal verbs get confused and it is normal. Maybe you need to practice. For example, look Neri's opinion. If you want to understand more, if you want to practice more, you can search information on internet. We have many different phrasal verbs. Wow, we have many. Es como cuando nosotros les explicaba yo la vez pasada, cuando decimos me encuentro entre la espada y la pared. O sea, no es que yo me encuentre verdaderamente entre una espada y una pared, sino que significa I'm between in a hard situation. So, phrasal verbs, you need to practice. So, in this case, the last example in the last dynamic and the last exercise is this one. Please, everybody go to this page. Exercise number 3. Complete the second sentence with a phrasal verb. From the box, so it means the same as the first. Change the form if necessary. Cuando dice que si vamos a cambiar la forma, si es necesario, significa que probablemente, tal vez, algún phrasal verb lo tenemos que poner en pasado. Tengo los phrasal verb pick up. ¿Qué significaba pick up?
Recoger.
Take after.
Cuidar.
O parecerse. Thank you. Turn down.
Renunciar.
Renunciar o rechazar o abandonar también. Take off. Quitarse. Como decimos, quitarte los zapatos. Take off your shoes. Look after.
Cuidar.
Look de. After. Y la última, turn up.
Ocupar. Llegar, aparecer.
Ok, aparecer o llegar. Puede ser arrive o puede ser turn up. Por ejemplo, lo único que yo voy a hacer es utilizar la misma oración, pero le voy a incluir el phrasal verb. La primera dice, I will pick up, in this case, I'll pick you up at half past 7. O sea, yo te voy a pasar recogiendo a qué horas? At siete. Half
la past siete. Pasada las 7.
Yep. Excelente. Letter B. They offer him a place at the university, but he refused it. Voy a, en este caso, la palabra refused. ¿Cómo quedaría entonces? ¿Con qué phrasal verb la voy a sustituir?
Turn down.
Let's see, vamos a ver. Excellent. They offer him a place at the university, but he turning down. O sea que en vez de decir refuse it, ocupamos el phrase adverb he turning down. O sea, en este caso, no aceptó el trabajo, lo rechazó. Letter C. Can you please, I need a volunteer, Jackie, welcome. Can you please help me to read, Jackie, letter C? Thank you.
He always arrives at parties, windows, and invitation.
¿Cuál es la palabra que voy a reemplazar? Arrives. ¿Y cuál voy a poner? Muy bien. He always turn up. La palabra que voy a sustituir, es arrives. He always turn up at parties without an invitation. Thank you. Can you please, let's see, Valeria, help me to read letter D.
Dave isn't like he's that.
Ok, ¿cuáles son las palabras que voy a sustituir?
Like.
Like.
Muy bien, ¿cómo quedaría la oración?
Dave doesn't take after his dad.
Dave doesn't take after his dad.
Oh.
Doesn't take after his dad. Yo lo puse en este caso en presente. Doesn't take after his dad. Thank you. Kevin, can you please letter E?
When you come inside, you should remove your coat and hat.
Okay, ¿cuál palabra voy a sustituir por un phrase verb?
Remove.
Remove. ¿Y qué phrase verb sería remove?
Take off.
Let's see. Excellent. When you come inside, you should, en vez de decir remove, utilizo el phrase verb take off, que significa quitarse. En este caso, tu abrigo y tu sombrero. You should take off your coat and hat. Thank you, Mari. Letter A, please. My neighbor.
My neighbor has to care for his mother who is very old.
¿Cuál es la palabra que voy a sustituir?
Care for.
Care.
Care for, excelente. ¿Por cuál?
For look after.
For look after. Muy bien, sí, ok. My neighbor has to look after his mother, who is very old, quien es muy anciana. Any question, please, students, 5, 4. Pregunta, ¿les he dejado algún laboratorio? Sí, se los dejé, ¿verdad? De los phrase adverbs, si no me equivoco. ¿Me acuerdan, porfa?
Yes.
Yes.
¿Verdad?
Yes.
Excelente. Yes, muy bien, teacher. Chicos. Voy a cerrar este tema. Me gustaría dejarles me gustaría hacerles un pequeño examen de estos phrase adverbs de los que acabamos de ver, pero les voy a mandar el link para que lo tengan ustedes, para que lo puedan hacer entre la semana. Ok, chicos. In this case, we are going to finish with this one. In this case, I have 1-2 videos and I have the last dynamic. No sé si el tiempo me va a alcanzar. Ok, en lo que yo explico, en esta parte de acá, tratémosla, por favor, de copiar las palabras. O si usted tiene a very good memorized, can you please take a picture in your mind and try to answer the questions according to the video. Es para los que tienen memoria fotográfica. Question number one. Vero, ¿me ayudas a leerla, porfa? Thank you.
Describe your house.
Describe.
Describe your house.
House.
House in Bend.
Okay, thank you. Can you please, Carla, number two?
Describe your perfect house.
Thank you. Naomi, number three.
What would you like to have a house in the city or out of the city?
Excellent, thank you. Question one. Describe tu casa. If you want, you can invent. Usted puede inventar. Question number two. Describe your perfect house. Teacher, ¿y cuál es la diferencia entre la uno y la dos? Que en la primera, usted me va a describir la casa que tiene ahorita. Si usted quiere, puede inventar. No es necesario decir la verdad. Número dos, la diferencia es que usted me va a describir cuál sería la casa ideal, la casa de sus sueños. Número tres. Would you like to have a house in the city or out of the city? ¿Te gustaría tener una casa en la ciudad o afuera de la ciudad? Related with the question number one is very easy because, for example, you say, okay, my house is big or my house is small. In my house, there are 3 bedrooms, 1 bathroom, a living room, a kitchen, and a big garden. Simply. Describe your perfect house. Oh, well, teacher, my perfect house is with third floor, con 3 plantas, 3 pisos, with 3 floors, with a big garden with roses and trees. I would like to have a swimming pool. The perfect house for me is a house that has 5 bedrooms, 2 living rooms, a balcony, a fireplace, and a nice view, according to question number 3. Would you like to have a house in the city or out of the city? Well, in my case, I would like to have a house in the city because I like to go to the cinema, I like to go to the malls, I like to go to the market. So I would like to have a house in the city. Now, we are going to watch a video related with this video. And please, students, pay attention.
Welcome to my house.
Anne, you have a nice garden. Flowers and trees are so beautiful.
Thank you. My family planted them in last spring. Let's go inside.
Oh, this is the living room.
Yes. My family usually watch TV and talk in here.
What about your room? Where is it?
Here, come in.
Oh, it looks so much neater than I thought.
So, I guess you sleep and study here.
That's right. Why don't you take a look around?
Are these only books you have?
Nope. There is a study room on the opposite of this room.
Wow. Can I see it?
Sure thing. Follow me.
I'm hungry. Anne, do you have something to eat?
All right. My mom made some cupcakes. Let's go to the kitchen.
Yay! Hooray! Oh, Anne, where's the bathroom?
It's right next to my room.
Okay, gotcha.
Okay, now we're going to start. I'm going to choose, well, do we have any volunteer, please? 5, 4, 3, 2.
Teacher.
Thank you, Berito. I'm going to, okay, can you please, before to continue, can you help me to choose the next student? Para que esté preparado. Yes, Vero?
Neri.
Okay, thank you, Neri. Creo que Berito no me entendió. Okay, can you, okay. Question number one, Vero. Describe your house.
My house is a small. Your green. Finish. It's a small. It's,
okay. It's, thank you. Question number 2. Describe your perfect house.
My perfect house, 3 plants,
Floors. Floor. Para decir pisos es floors.
Floors. Garden, beautiful.
A beautiful garden.
A beautiful garden. Color green.
Okay.
Green color.
Would you like to have a house in the city or out the city?
In out the city.
Why?
Because more mejor.
It is better, okay.
It's better.
Okay. Okay, thank you. Oh, that's it. You're finished or finished. Not? Okay, thank you. Miren, les voy a pedir que por el tiempo seamos así bastante específicos. No es necesario que hable el gran montón. Just to be specific with your information. Yes, Neri, please, the next student. Can you please help me to choose quickly? I have Ale, I have Jackie, Carla, Kevin, Mari, Naomi, Israel, Rachel or Valeria? Israel. Okay, Israel, nos preparamos. Neri, describe your house.
My house is medium. One living room in the kitchen, one master, three room, and two bathroom.
Describe your perfect house.
My perfect house is a big swimming pool, big garden, big master room, big bathroom, and two floors.
Excellent. Would you like to have a house in the city or out the city?
In my opinion, I want to like up off the city.
Okay, why?
Is for natural.
It's for the nature.
It's perfect.
Okay. Nice. Thank you, Neri. Israel, can you please help me to choose the next student? Ale Martinez, Jackie, Carla, Kevin, Mari, Naomi, Rachel, or Valeria?
Naomi,
nos preparamos. Israel, can you please describe your house? Thank you. Your microphone?
Okay.
Okay, yes. Excellent. Thank you. Describe your house, please.
I'm ready. My house is big. There are two bedroom, a living room, a kitchen, two gardens.
Okay. Describe your perfect house.
My perfect house is two floors. The bedroom and two living rooms.
Okay. Question three.
Two garden.
Okay. Nice. Would you like to have a house in the city or out the city?
Oh, I like out city because. Mm-hmm. Because very
si queremos decir por ejemplo okay, si queremos decir por la naturaleza, it's for the nature. Si queremos decir porque es tranquilo, nature. Because it is quiet.
Yes, it is Estrés.
And, okay, it is in stressful.
A lot of vehicles, a lot of cars.
Uh-huh, the traffic, uh-huh.
Contamination.
Contamination, uh-huh.
Yes. I like out. Yes.
Okay, you prefer to have a house out of the city. Thank you, Israel. Naomi, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, can you please, I don't know who's, do we have any volunteer? Valeria, Rachel, Mari, Kevin, Carla, Jackie. Sí, okay, thank you, Rachel. Rachel one, Mari number two. Naomi, describe your house, please.
Well, my house is small, have three rooms, a bathroom, a nice living room, and two gardens.
Excellent. Describe your perfect house.
My perfect house is a tree house because I love the nature.
The nature. Okay. And would you like to have a house in the city or out the city?
Out of the city because I think it is better and calm.
And calm. Ah, muy bien y tranquilo. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Rachel, question one. Please, Mari, be ready. Describe your house, Rachel.
In my house, there are three rooms, one living room. I have one bathroom and the kitchen. And that's it.
Perfect. And describe what can be your perfect house.
I want a big house with two floors, and the first floor I want a living room, two rooms, and the second floor I want three rooms and three bathrooms.
Okay.
And I want the big garden.
Nice. Excellent. In your opinion, would you like to have a house in the city or out the city?
I would like out of the city because the tree is better for my health.
Okay. Excellent. Nice. Thank you. Mari, question number one, se prepara Jackie. Mari, describe your house, please.
Okay, my house is small. Have one living room and a kitchen with the dining room. And the big yard only have two rooms and one bathroom.
Okay, can you please describe your perfect house?
Okay, my perfect house have a one floor located in the beach with the three rooms, pool, and the cocktail bar, and the big yard.
Nice. And would you like to have a house in the city or out the city?
For me, it's much better out the city because I like the beach and the mountain.
Excellent. Nice answer. Thank you, Mari. Jackie, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Excellent. Thank you. Se prepara Ale Martinez. Jackie, can you please describe your house?
Okay, my house is medium. Have five rooms, two bathrooms, a small garden, and a very small kitchen.
Nice. Can you please describe your perfect house?
My perfect house is big with five rooms, three bathrooms, a big garden with many plants, and a big kitchen.
In your opinion, Jackie, would you like to have a house in the city or out the city?
I prefer out of the city because they are bigger house with a bigger garden.
Thank you. Nice. Ale, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Excellent. Can you please, Kevin, be ready too? Okay, Ale, can you describe your house, please?
My house is small with 4 rooms.
Okay, thank you.
My perfect house is a big house with a pool.
Okay. Would you like to have a house in the city or out the city?
Out of the city, because out of town for naturaleza.
Nature. Okay, thank you, nice. Can you please, Valeria, nos preparamos? Yes, Kevin, question one, describe your house, please.
Okay, my house is small. It has three bedrooms and a bathroom and a yard.
Excellent. And your perfect house?
My perfect house has 2 floors and 3 bedrooms, and bathrooms, sorry, and a big yard.
Okay, and would you like to have a house in the city or out the city?
I would like to have a house in the city because I love to go to mall.
Okay, excellent. Thank you, Kevin. Vale, are you ready?
Yes.
Nice. Let's see who's missing. Carlita, right? Nos preparamos. Yes, Vale, describe your house, please.
And my house is medium. There are 3 bedrooms and 1 bathroom and 1 kitchen.
Nice. Can you describe your perfect house?
My perfect house have the 2 flowers. And big garden with 4 bedroom and blue color house, a medium kitchen and 2 bathroom.
Oh, nice. Would you like to have a house, Valeria, out the city or in the city?
Depend, because it's the location of the house. In, for example, in the city for different places, and out in the quiet or relaxed.
Excellent respuesta. Nice, thank you. Carlita, you are the last one. Are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher. Okay, describe your house.
My house is medium.
It
has 1 bedroom and 2 bedroom. Finish. My perfect house is 2 floors. Beautiful big garden. Big bedroom. In my opinion.
Yes, would you like to have us in the city or out the city?
I like in the city because I like to go to the mall.
That's it. Okay, thank you. Okay, students, the next. Vamos con el último video. En lo que yo explico las preguntas, please taking notes. The next video is about jobs. O sea, trabajos, profesiones. Question number one, what do you do for a living? Question number two, what's your favorite profession and why? And number three, mention at least 5 jobs. Teacher, needed. Okay, ya lo explico. Mention at least 5 jobs in English. What do you do for a living? ¿Qué haces para vivir? O sea, ¿a qué te dedicas? Yo sé que tengo aquí estudiantes. En ese caso, teacher, I'm a student. Yo soy estudiante. I don't work. Yo no trabajo. Para las personas que trabajan, usted, ah, teacher, yes. Y si usted quiere inventar, también puede inventar. Teacher, I'm a doctor, I work in a hospital, I help people, etc. Podemos inventar. What's your favorite profession and why? Teacher, my favorite profession is to be an engineer because I like to build things. Teacher, my favorite profession is to be a vet because I like and I love animals. Teacher, my favorite profession is to be a doctor because I like to help people, etc. Number three, mention at least, por lo menos, 5 jobs in English. 5 profesiones en inglés. So, please, students, watch the video and then be ready with your answers.
Hey everyone, let's talk about jobs. I wonder what he does and what does she do? Here we go. He's a carpenter. He's a carpenter. She's a hairdresser. She's a hairdresser. He's a construction worker. He's a construction worker. She's a nurse. She's a nurse. He's a doctor. He's a doctor. She's an office worker. She's an office worker. He's a firefighter. He's a firefighter. She's a shop assistant. She's a shop assistant. He's a police officer. He's a police officer. She's a teacher. She's a teacher. That was great stuff, everyone. Let's do it one more time. In a big voice, listen and repeat. He's a carpenter. She's a hairdresser. He's a construction worker. She's a nurse. He's a doctor. She's an office worker. He's a firefighter. She's a shop assistant. He's a police officer. She's a teacher. Well done, everyone. You did it. Thanks for watching.
Okay, I'm going to continue. La persona que vaya contestando se va saliendo de la sala. Do we have any volunteer? Five.
Mari.
Okay, Mari. Mari number one. Vero number two. Que son los micrófonos que se me activaron. Okay, Mari. What do you do for a living?
Okay, si me escucha, si vea.
Perfect, yes.
Okay, for the moment I work in a warehouse.
Okay, and what do you do?
I pick in and store the old products. That's it.
Okay, excellent, nice, okay. What's mm-hmm. your favorite profession, Mari, and why?
My favorite profession is to be a forensic doctor because it's a different job.
And it has a very good salary too. Number three, mention at least 5 jobs in English.
Okay. The first, nurse. Second, firefighter. The third, carpenter, hairdresser, and office worker.
Okay, thank you. Before you leave the class, remember, students, tomorrow you are going to have an oral presentation. The question is, what's the question?
What is the because it's important learn to English, maybe?
Yes, how important is to learn languages, maybe? Can you please, a student, help me? What was the question? Miren, que tengo varios grupos y a todos los grupos siempre les dejo preguntas. So, please, can you please help me to say the question, please?
How important is to learn a new language?
Excelente, ya me había asustado, pensé que no se las habían mandado. How important is to learn a new language? Please, be ready for your oral presentation for tomorrow. I'm going to start with your oral presentations. Thank you. Good night, Mari. Thank you. Yes, Vero. In your opinion, Vero, what do you do for a living? ¿A qué te dedicas o qué haces? ¿De qué trabajas?
Sales newspaper. Sales newspaper.
Thank you. What's your favorite profession and why?
Veterinary. Because help animals.
And number three, mention at least 5 jobs in English.
Shop assist, police's officer.
Police officer.
Officer worker, teacher, nurse, doctor.
Excellent, thank you, Vero. See you, good night. Volunteer, Valeria 1, Kevin number 2, Rachel number 3. Okay, Vale, what do you do for a living?
In the moment, I work CAM in the recrutamiento, recruiting.
Requirement?
Requiring the people.
Okay, what's your favorite profession and why?
My favorite profession is doctor because it's better salary.
Okay, okay, nice. Mention at least 5 jobs in English.
A doctor, architect, nurse, office worker, and hairdresser.
Excellent. Thank you, Vale. Good night.
Bye.
Yes. Kevin, what do you do for a living?
Right now, I'm a student.
Okay, and what's your favorite profession?
For me, my favorite profession is be a translator.
Excellent. And mention at least 5 jobs in English.
Okay, teacher, doctor, vet, and policeman, and firefighter.
Okay, nice. See you tomorrow, Kevin. Good night. Rachel, question 1.
In this moment, I'm studying.
You're a student. Okay. What's your favorite profession?
My favorite profession is to be teacher in the kindergarten because I look after children.
Nice. Okay. And question 3. The 5 jobs.
Nurse, doctor, office worker, firefighter, and teacher.
Thank you. Good night, Rachel. See you. Volunteer.
Jackie.
Neri.
Carla.
Jackie 1, Neri 2, Carlita 3. Jackie, question 1. What do you do for a living?
I am vet. I job in I vet.
Okay. And what's your favorite profession?
My favorite profession is vet because I love animals, I like help animals, and I love medicine.
And 5 mention, excuse me, mention 5 jobs in English.
Office worker, carpenter, teacher, hairdresser, nurse.
Thank you, good night. Next, Neri, right? Question 1, Neri, what do you do for a living?
I have housekeeping.
Okay. What's your favorite profession?
My favorite profession is in business. Tener un negocio, a business.
Okay, to have a business, okay.
Because being me a boss.
Okay, and mention five jobs in English.
Engineer, nurse, carpenter, doctor, and police officer.
Thank you, Neri. See you tomorrow. Good night. Okay, Carlita, what do you do for a living?
I am a student.
And what's your favorite profession?
My favorite profession is veterinary because I like the animals.
And mention five jobs.
Shop assistant, police office, teacher, construction worker, nurse.
Thank you. Nice. Volunteer.
Ale.
Okay, Ale. And Ale number one, Israel number two, Naomi number three. Ale, what do you do for a living?
I am a student.
Excellent. And what's your favorite profession?
My favorite profession is teacher because she teaches the student.
Excellent. And mention five jobs in English.
Firefighter, police officer, nurse, teacher, and nurse.
Okay, thank you, Ale. Nos preparamos para mañana. Israel, question number one. Good night, Ale. What do you do for a living?
I am a teacher.
Okay, and what's your favorite profession?
Salesman.
Okay, and mention five jobs in English.
Teacher, engineer, construction worker, carpenter, secretary.
Okay, thank you. Good night, Israel. See you tomorrow. Nos preparamos para la pregunta de mañana. Naomi, question number one. What do you do for a living?
I'm a student.
You are a student. What's your favorite profession?
Veterinary.
Vet.
Because I adore look after of the animals.
Excellent, muy bien. Mention at least five jobs in English.
Nurse, doctor, carpenter, office worker, and teacher.
Excelente. Hey, muy bien, hija, te felicito. Nos preparamos mañana con la respuesta de por qué es importante aprender un nuevo idioma. Bye, hija. Good night.
Thanks.
You're welcome.